Okay, so the recording has started. Good morning, everyone. I hope everyone that has joined is doing well. Welcome to day two of week five. And as always, congratulations for getting this far. I'm really happy to see everyone here. So are there any announcements from the other members of the 10 Academy team? No, okay. We've got a birthday here, but I don't think the person whose birthday it was yesterday is actually in the stand-up, but I'll just let everyone know so that you can wish him. Tedese Kabere's birthday was yesterday. So whenever he watches this, happy birthday, happy belated birthday from the 10 Academy team. So if there are no announcements, I am just going to go down the list of everyone who is in the stand-up and we can talk about any challenges you've been facing or blockers. So let me start with Amon. Good morning. If you can hear me, please let us know how you've been doing with Den Academy, and if you have anything else to add outside of Den Academy, please go ahead. Aman, can you hear me? Okay, not sure if he can hear me or they can hear me. Binyam, you are up next. Can you update us, please?
Okay, good morning, Kerry. Can you hear me?
Good morning. Yes, I can hear you.
All right, so yesterday we're working hard to solve the an error that has been bugging us for a couple of days, and last night we've managed to solve it. So that's a win for us. But right now we're faced with another problem, which is we're not being able to save the model we've managed to develop. We'll probably manage to solve that as well, but currently that's where we are. So that's it. Thank you.
Okay. Is there anyone, any tutors from the technical team that can assist Binium with that blocker that he just mentioned? Okay. I see Tedessa has joined the stand-up. So happy birthday, happy belated birthday from everyone at the 10 Academy team. If everyone in the stand-up can just drop him a message in the chat so that he can see that he is appreciated. And we will move on to Beruk. Please update us on how things have been going for you.
Hello everyone. I hope you can hear me.
Yeah, can hear you.
Okay, so yesterday we tried to continue our progress on the tasks. We tried to make a discussion with our group, and also today until the decision we are on our discussion with our teams. We tried to solve a bug that we had on our API development, and so we are trying to make a progress, and we're actually doing good, I can say. And we had one bad news for our team. We lost one of our team member, Aiden. I can't say much by this time. Maybe She will come and give us more thing about the situation, but that's also the thing that we faced. So she is the second member we lost from our team, and that's bad news. And we are happy that we were in the same group, and she was one of our best friend and teammates. So we are sorry to lose her, and we wish all the good things for her. Yeah, so that's all.
Okay, I'm really sorry to hear that. Piruk, is your team going to be the remainder of your team? How are you managing the work now that you've lost two members?
Yeah, so what we are planning is try to cover the things we were assigned for them. So we will make some kind of shift, and we will try our best to complete every task with the members we had.
Okay, but remember to reach out for help if and when you need it. Ghazan, you've got your hand up. Let us hear from you.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, thank you. Good morning, everyone. First, I should say sorry about yesterday. I was preparing myself to present our progress for YAPVAL, but unfortunately, I'm in the middle of the conference, the power was gone, and I didn't even connect to, I mean, using my phone too. So, to just give some updates, we have already completed our task one, and we have started task two. From task one, we have already generated our required data for our model, and for the task two, we have already trying some models. Yes, we have built some structures, and we try to test them using with simple data whether the code we are using is correct or not. So that we have some models which pass our requirement, which means we can use them with all of the data we have for the training on our virtual AWS. And adding to that, we have by myself, I have already trying to use the AWS, and I'm trying to clone those data which are required for the training, and I already upload all of the data, I mean the files required for the whole training, including my requirement text. So it looks this one is our status, and if my members, my team members already attending on the conference, they can add something if they have in their own hand.
Okay, thank you so much for the update. So it sounds like you've been very productive. Is there anything specific, any specific challenges that you're facing?
Yeah, as the first thing, regarding the challenges, those the concepts which are most of the time we face new concepts, so that handling them and trying to implement them takes time, which is one constraint. And the second thing, there are a lot of configurations regarding to, especially when we work on local system and when we move to the Google Colab or AWS, those configurations take our time. Since we all know the time is our main deadlock here. So regardless of the understanding the concept, those things are our challenges, but we distribute them and we drop down, drop down the scenarios, and we distribute those scenarios, and we try to test them individually, so that we can, if one of our member make them work, we follow that, and we try to move fast.
Okay, so it's mainly time management or time that is the main challenge, if I'm understanding you correctly.
Yeah, even if the time is one of our resources, even for example, I was having a trouble with my machine, which I try to run my model, and I didn't see that I feed all of the data I have for my machine, and it doesn't respond to me, and I try to make it back almost half of the day I already spent on that. So regardless of the time, those resources need special attention, especially once we run them and they crash our system. So those cases also the other one.
Okay, please reach out to your technical tutors, because I don't think I can properly assist you with those issues. Martin, you have your hand up. So let's hear from you, and thank you, Ghazan, for your contribution.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Martin, go for it.
We've been working on our team together to complete the backend side of things, and also to ensure that we are able to do predictions and such things. So yesterday, that's what we were working on. Get us as the team to complete on deploying the backend part of the application, so that we can start working on the front-end side according to the way this task was. So I want to be in the front from today and tomorrow. And once we complete, I believe we will also be able to complete also being the report. Yeah, that's it on our side. One of our members, I think it's two of our members who are not available with us. That's Margaret and Edenwork. Yeah, Margaret and Edenwork. But we want to wish them all the best. It was a good thing, and it was a good time just working together with them. Yeah, so all the best to the two of them. I think that's all on my side. There was another blocker that I had just for the AWS server, but Yavibel has already sorted me out. So I want to now continue working.
Thanks so much. I'm glad that you've been making progress. Thank you. Daisy, please update us on your progress, your challenges. Share with the team, please.
Thank you, Kari. Gezahin is my team lead, and he's gone fast with regards to like the team progress. I won't delve much into that. Personally, I'm working on the front end for our application using Shimlit, and I'm also just trying to learn React as well to see if I can use the same in the implementation. And on that front, I don't have any blockers as of now. Thank you.
Thanks so much. Okay, Dynamos, if I'm saying that correctly, good morning. If you can speak, please update us on your progress.
Not you, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, so I'm actually part of the design team, Daisy's team. So personally, I've been working on the backing. I was able to set up everything required. We are using Fast API to develop the backing, which is going to predict the audios coming from the Streamlit dashboard, And if we have time, we will also try to come up with an application, which is also going to query the backend API to get the results. So of course, I've been working on that, and I have already somehow completed a backend, but I expect a model to test if it's working correctly. And most of us from our team, we are having trouble trying to come up with the working model. So it's taking so much time to run 50 pods or something. So I'm currently trying to build a model. So that's where I am.
Okay, thanks. So your challenge is, okay, I think I got it. If anyone from the technical team can assist, please do so. Taiwan, if you're here and you can speak, please update us on your progress and anything, any challenges you've been facing.
Hi, everyone.
Yeah.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So me and my team has been working on the modeling and the modeling part, and from the modeling part, the blocker we were facing was finding the best architecture or model to fit our or to predict what's expected. And aside from that, we've been working on the front end and back end to embed our model or the prediction we made. So we've been progressing good on that. We have a plan to test it today. Aside from finding the best model, we're doing good. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for your contribution. I'm really glad to hear that you are doing well. Malako, if you can speak, please update us on your progress. Do you have any challenges that you've been facing, please share with us. Okay, I'm not sure if Malako can hear me. Meron, if you can speak, please update us on your progress.
Hey, hello, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
So basically, I think as a group, Binyam has mentioned everything that's going on. I think our group is trying its best and we are progressing day by day. He did mention we were facing some bug issue, but that is fixed now. And currently I'm also working on the modeling and trying to figure out the bug. So that's it.
Okay, thanks so much. Rafa, good morning. If you can speak, please update us on your progress, any challenges you've been facing. Okay, I'm not sure if Rafa can speak. Remit, if you can speak, please update us on your progress. Okay, Rafa is going to type. Remit, if you can speak. Okay, Samrawat, if you can speak, and I'm sorry if I'm not pronouncing your name properly. Please update us when you progress.
Hello, everyone.
Good morning. Yes,
good morning. Okay, my progress for this week is I'm not able to understand the modeling. So my group mates are working on it. I'm working on the front end.
Okay, and you've not faced any challenges or blockers?
On the front end, no, not yet.
Okay, good to hear. And remember to always reach out to your team and technical tutors for help, please, because as we are moving further into training, everyone here has to produce very good, high quality of work. So please reach out for help. Samuel, if you can speak. Oh, thank you, Samuel. Samuel, if you can speak, let us hear your progress. Okay, not sure. Stella, if you can speak. Okay, go for it, Stella.
Good morning. I hope that you can hear me.
Yes, good morning.
Okay, so just as Hewan and Samrawi said, my group has made some progress on the back end and front end, but we're still working on getting a good model to get a better prediction. And that has been our challenge. So we're working on going back to pre-processing and seeing if that can improve the results we got, and also maybe just finding a better model. Yeah, I personally feel that I'm learning, and I'm energized to forge forward. Yeah, enjoy the rest of the day, guys.
Thank you. I'm glad that you are doing well, and your group as well. Today, say happy birthday, happy belated birthday. I hope you enjoyed your day. Please update us on your progress and tell us how your birthday was, if you can speak.
Okay, I can speak. Good morning.
Good morning.
First of all, I would like to thank you for all wish you made for me, and thank you. I hope we will going to celebrate one day in person. And as the duty, our progress is just as Stella, Samri, and Sabrawit, and another members are clarified. We are working on the modeling issues, and as we have classified the task, but basically all of us are stick to the modeling task, because to get a good prediction, we are struggling to have that one. And we had, as a blogger, we had a GPU problem, so we are working on it. We get some recommendation from Yabibal, and we are just implementing that one. Maybe we will correct it by today, and we will have a good model, and we will give it to the back end and the front end workers. So this is our progress. After all, Stella and Samri raised another thing, so thank you.
Thank you. And once again, happy birthday. Tesfaye, good morning. If you can speak.
Okay. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Okay, so I'm in the same team as Tadesa, Stella, Samroit, and Abel. We have divided our task into three. One team does the modeling, one team does front end, and one team does the back end. So the back end and front end seem to be ready. They are waiting on the best model in order to predict from the audio that we get. So we are working on the modeling part. Most of us are working on the modeling part because that's the entire point of the challenge. So we are working on the making the modeling good. So yeah, that's our progress. And for the progress, working on different machines and so on, where some of our challenges, as Tadesa mentioned, the GPU problem where is also a problem which we will try to solve by today, so that we can reach for the Thursday submission. Yeah, that's our progress.
Thanks so much. Thank you. Theodros, good morning. If you can speak, go for it and update us.
Okay, good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So we've been basically working in teams. Half of the team was working on part of the team was working on the dashboard part, and the other was is working on the modeling. We also had a meeting yesterday, and there's progress on both sides. As a blocker, yesterday we had there was no space left on our instance, so we were not able to actually work on that part. But that issue has now been fixed, and we are now progressing forward.
Okay. Thank you for sharing. Titus, if you can speak, please update us on your progress.
Okay. Hi, everybody.
Good morning.
Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. So most of my group members have already spoken, giving updates on our progress. So so far we've managed to finish or basically complete the front end and the back end. It's the model that we are still working on, because we don't really have a good model for prediction. So like we have decided to work together on modeling and completing it, so that we hit the deadline. So basically it's the modeling that we are currently working on. And yeah, we have made good progress. Yeah.
Okay. Good to hear that you are making progress. Thank you. Yedidia, please update us on how you have been doing, if you can speak.
Okay, hello everyone. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. So I think Pedros has already updated, but just to add up, yesterday, just one of the progress that we faced was the storage of our server instance was full, but I think it's now fixed. And I was personally having a problem accessing the GPU that was also fixed last week. And part of the team that's working on the web part, I think they have already completed or almost completed the web development part. So they are waiting for the modeling part to be finished, and we hope to finish that as fast as possible and finish the project for Thursday submission.
Okay, thank you so much. And then Jonas Tedese, if you can speak, please let us know how you've been doing.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay. I'm in the team of Gazahin and DA, Dynamo. I was taking part in the modeling, so I'm currently doing the modeling tasks. I have done the pre-processing and managed to get the data that I can feed for the model. Now I am on the modeling part, so I'm struggling with few concepts that I have to understand. So today I'm going to be doing the modeling and try to run on the AWS.
Okay, thank you so much. I think that is all that all the trainees have spoken. Thank you. Yababal, do you have anything to add regarding the technical training? Does anyone from the 10 Academy team have anything to add?
No, thanks, Gary. And from my side, actually, it's okay. I think it seems like people are in good shape. Definitely, you know, don't try to put things to at the end. So prepare the front end and back end, test it with kind of dummy data, as well as also just try to think about presentation of it, like how you will present it, because there will be like you will be required. And then also, you know, what are the kind of data that was some of the things we said, you know, so are there teams that are exploring also to integrate other data sets? For example, can you specialize, it may not be accurate for a general speech to text, but could a few of the people in the group, can they look at, for example, specializing it for something that's more relevant, let's say commanding, you know, because we shared some of the data. So things like that. So how can you make it, you know, like very close to application? As well, if we are able to, I think I have to see, but there might be a tutorial also on kind of trying to deploy a skill in Alexa. Of course, it's coming late now, but you could also on your own try to see, some of the team can see. So literature review in that way means that, like, you know, some of the team can look at just the future, and while some others look at the past, which is, you know, what other people has done, and then some people do the present, look at the present, which is basically, you know, what the data you have and the model and you want to optimize. So I would say I think the divisions in most of the people in the most of the teams fields seems really good. There is definitely people not doing it parallel, and that should be the case. So great, hopefully that your experience also in AWS is smooth at the point. And if I notice memories are full, usually memories are full if you just put them in a normal fast disk, which is in the home directory. It will not be full if you are putting it in. So if whatever slow data that you don't use, models that you kind of are already developed, you can move them to the notebook directory. In that case, your memory will be freed. So just think about those elements. But if I notice that memories are very full because of something, then I will try to also investigate if there are caching and stuff. So I will help in that dimension. But hopefully, I think the experience seems smoother. If there are any other issues that you are experiencing, definitely, you know, put them in Slack. I will notice, but Slack is quite dead. So I don't see that much activity. I assume that is a good thing, even if it's not a good thing to be so silent. But it's because maybe all of you have your own group channels. So maybe you are discussing and solving issues there. So overall, a good feeling. So keep up the good work.
Thank you. Gezayan, please go ahead. And then I see Abel and Amal have joined. I'm not sure if you joined a bit late, but then please go ahead and update us, and then we can close the session.
Okay. Actually, I have one question for Yapaval. Before we just use the resource which is provided from AWS, is there any other options to track our ML model? For example, I was seeing one inside Comet ML, which tracks to all of the experiments on our ML model. So is there any other resources which can be used for before we jump into AWS? You may recommend that.
But I don't understand. So is that for to track your model?
Yeah, to track our experiment. Just the metrics which require the hyperparameters and the like, if we need them before we jump into the AWS?
But AWS is not, I don't understand. AWS is just a machine, right? It's just, it's a machine. It's like your machine, a computer machine. So what do you mean by, because like the two are different. So for model tracking, we have been using MLflow, right? So not model tracking, but much more. So there are two things about it, model artifacts and being able to history of to manage, just like Git manages your code, to manage your model associated things, you would use MLflow. Now MLflow can run anywhere, right? So it can run on your computer, it can run on AWS machine. So the AWS is just a machine. It's basically nothing more than a bit powerful, expandable computer. That's it. So I think it's before moving, like the concept of before moving doesn't seem like, so you have to see if you understood correctly what is a cloud computing. In a cloud computing, it's nothing more than it has a CPU, a GPU, a memory, right? And you are able, just your win, basically your, you are just SSHing to just be able to access. It has no any other thing. It has operating system like your computer, right? So now you can install in it anything. You can install MLflow, you can install Airflow, you can install many things in that kind of system. But of course, the more you install, just like your computer, it will slow down because it's not only one computer that you use, but it's a computer that your group uses. So everyone has basically a director user, is a user in that one. So that's why sometimes one has to manage that. But if you want now, all of you want to manage your artifacts in one MLflow, you can install MLflow in that instance as a sudo, and then you have it. Like then you will basically, all of you track, basically send your artifacts or metrics, whatever there. So, and I think that's, does that make it clear, design?
Yeah, that's clear. Thank you.
Okay, Abel and Amal, can you just update us, Abel first, and then I guess we can close out the session for today.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
So our group members have met today, an hour before this meeting, and we have been working on separately model building and working on the dashboard website. And as other my group members mentions, we have been working to meet the deadline on the back end and the front end. So we're working fast to meet the Thursday deadline. So we're working on these things.
Okay, thank you. Amal, let's hear from you. We can't hear you, Amal. Amal, we can't hear you. Okay. Okay, she has a problem with them. Okay. Then I think that if there is nothing else to add from anyone, we can stop the recording and end today's stand up. Thank you, everyone who joined, and have a good day further.
Bye, everyone.